Hello to friends and welcome to my channel. So it has been some time that I had any Kubey knife here on my table. So I was really happy to find out that Kubey did actually produce a few models in micarta, and that is in the brown color micarta variant. So I jumped on it and bought them. So stay tuned for more videos. If you like this brand, I certainly do, because they, in my opinion, are one of the best value offers that you can get if you are searching for a really decent knife with micarta scales. So this is the Kubey Ruckus. The model number is KU314M. They have it marked as 10. Definitely, as you can see, is brown. I also appreciate that Kubey has a really really nice packaging system here, so they will nicely package and seal the knife itself so that it does not take any kind of rust and issues while in storage. So this is definitely a big thumbs up in my book. Also, we have only a paper box. So all the money is going towards the product and nothing is wasted. This is what I like to see with every company. We certainly do not need any kind of fancy boxes, fancy pouches, challenge coins, and so on. So this is a Sherif Manganas design. Hopefully I have not butchered his name. So definitely did not hear about this designer. Overall, the knife feels really, really lightweight. I will tell you the weight, of course. But firstly, when I grabbed it, it felt really nice to fit in the hand. This really nice ergonomics. This, what I would say, something like forward finger guard is implemented into the design. So let me give you the specifications. So we have a overall length of 20.3 centimeters, that is 8 inches. The blade is 8.4 centimeters or 3.3 inches. The width is 3 centimeters or 1.16 inches. The thickness is 2.7 millimeters or 0.1 inch. The handle length is 12 centimeters, 4.7 inches, and the thickness is 1.3 centimeters, 0.5 inches. That is measured without the pocket clip. On the blade, we have AUS 10, which is a decent older stainless steel. Definitely a good choice right there. Kubey has been using this still in the past, and there is nothing wrong with it. Nowadays, of course, we have much better but also a more expensive steel, so no problems there. The blade features what they call a bead blasted drop point profile, but when I inspected this blade, it looks really like a really fine type of bead blast. Almost, I would dare to say this is some kind of stone washing, but they call it bead blasting, because usually bead blasted finishes will have some uniform finish, like with painted with spray paint, but this has crevices. You can see their texturing right there. So I don't know what's going on. Definitely it looks really nice to me. So edit bonus right there. The handles are made of your standard Chinese brown canvas micarta. This is not the OG stuff like the Kaiser did release a couple of years ago, but the standard standard canvas micarta that has been used by lots of companies like V on their CVV line, and also QSP and so on. So definitely it is something newer that they have been using in the past. We have stainless steel skeletonized nested liners. These are really nice and deeply skeletonized, so you can save on weight with these. Pivot assembly, it rides on KVT caged ball bearing washers. On the blade we have the Maker's Mark logo, OS 10 steel, Kubey logo on the other side, and probably that's it. There is also something going on the decorated pivot screw. I'd say probably it is the logo, Kubey logo. Maybe they done something new. Liner lock, which is really really smooth, so be careful, this will guillotine down and could hurt you if you are not fast enough to put your finger away. Nice centering, 3D milled black G10 partial backspacer. Have really nice oversized screws, which I prefer. Probably the same driver will be enough to disassemble the knife. Then we have nicely made flush screws on the pocket clip. This is a deep carry folded style with medium stiffness. So let's see how it fares into the pocket. Yeah, sure, no problems there. And this is how much it will be sticking out, so almost nothing. Maybe just a touch. Let's see the sharpness out of the box. So this is definitely nice and sharp, but I feel a little bit of tootiness on to the edge. So your favorite strop or ceramic rods will definitely make this knife even sharper. Forgot to mention that the deep carry pocket clip has a MB option. So for all of my left-handed carry users, friends, you can definitely have this one and change out the position of the pocket clip. So like I mentioned, this knife feels really, really lightweight, and it is 102.8 grams or 3.6 ounces. So definitely really nice. If you don't like the brown micarta, I'm happy to say that Kubey is making this one in 14 variants. So 14 variants, you can choose from different kinds of G10. Now let's see a few size comparisons. So like I mentioned, this is the standard micarta. So let's put in the picture the QSP Penguin and also CVV Elementum, which both are using the same style or type of micarta. These are also the Kesivo or Free Tiger model 956, also sporting the same micarta type. Let's continue with the red model. One, and also red model two. Spyderco and Dura. Spyderco Delica. So this really nice in between these venerable EDC designs. Since I mentioned it, here is the OG Kaiser pinch. And when I mentioned OG China Carta, then here is a Kubey Ruckus. It definitely has the same type of micarta, so definitely a couple of years have passed since this model was introduced, and back then this is what they had. So let me show you the differences. And don't get me wrong, the OG style of canvas micarta is definitely really nice and decent, has definitely a wider woven fabric, not that fine that on the new one. This in some places could pass also as a burlap style. And here is the comparison between these finishes. This one has also the bead busted finish, so hope you can. Yeah, the finish is really nice. And here is the QSP Raven with the new type of brown dark burlap micarta. From Bestech, I have the Bestech Man Dundee with the linen type micarta scales. Similar styled micarta from Petrified Fish, the Viking. Here is Spyderco Paramilitary 2. Rough Rider Peanut. It's a CGRB, a large feldspar. Another excellent EDC design in my opinion. Benchmade Bugout. And let's close it down with the K-Bar Dozer Folding Hunter. So now let's talk about the price. Like I mentioned, Kubey is one of those Chinese company who did try to give you the best possible value for your money. And the MSRP is $70, and here in Europe, since this is a new model, they cost around 42 euros. So let's translate that to dollars, and this one should be, I would say, around $45. I will try to link in the description a link if I find one in the US. So at the time when I'm making this video, I had only the European pricing. Don't know why. So it is what it is. So all informations. I try to update into the description down below. And of course, like I mentioned, these are made in China. So for opening method, we have the thumb stud and probably also front flipper if we are lucky enough. Yes, definitely doable. I don't know how safe it is. Probably not that safe, but yeah, you can do it. But definitely it will fling open with authority, without any problems. Like I mentioned, it rides on cage ball bearing washers, which are really, really, as you can see there, it glides open. So be very careful with this one, okay? So this was the Kubey Ruckus. If you have any questions, please leave comments down below. I'm more than happy to reply as soon as I can, of course. If you are a subscriber, thank you very much. Big thumbs up to you. And if you are not a subscriber, then please consider subscribing. Do not miss any future videos. With that being said, wish you a wonderful day. Hope to see you soon. Bye.